I can wait another day until I call you. Mm-hmm. You've only got my heart on a string and everything a flutter. But another lonely night might take forever.
Ebony
and ivory live together in perfect harmony, side by side on my piano keyboard. Oh Lord, why don't we? Side by side on my piano keyboard.
Hello, we are gathered here together because Paul McCartney has released his first solo album for 10 years. That is an album without wings or indeed without any group. And I'm here to talk to Paul about it and one or two other McCartney things, which is very nice for me and I hope it'll be nice for Paul. Paul, good evening, hello, welcome, and other expressions of greeting.
Good evening, Tom.
Why have you done a solo album at this stage of your career? Having
I couldn't
not
think
that
of anything else to do, actually. No, seriously, folks.
I mean, it's called McCartney 2, which applies to me. This is perhaps a follow-up to McCartney 1, 10 years ago.
Yeah.
Is it a follow-up?
Yeah, sort of, yeah. What happened was, originally just went into the studio to have a mess around. Because I was fed up of formally making records.
Possibly, purely from a song point of view.
Maybe actually. As I say, you know, this wasn't intended to be an album. I have a feeling now that like there's some interesting things on it. Certainly people haven't come up to me and said, oh, you can tell. That's the only thing. But I in a way I don't need to tell you that. And I could say, yeah, I wrote them all, and actually
sure.
Tony Brabham engineered it all. It's all been done professionally. But it could be right. It could be it's definitely the way I've always done it. But this was purposely to get things off my chest through this album. I really felt as though I was just going to be bored if I just walked into another studio, same old thing again, and wrote some songs. It was just something I had to do.
I mean, two
one of these days, as sort of talks about it, one
yes,
of these
yes,
days,
do,
swiftly. that's talking about one of these days when my feet are on the ground.
Well, that's something everybody can instantly relate to. Yes. Phrase, but and of course, two or three of them, two of them, anyway, contact at all.
Right? But one of them nearly did have some roots.
Which one was that?
This one called Frozen Jam, or in Japan it's called Frozen Japanese.
Now, is that, one has to ask this, is that in any way related to your slight problems?
No,
in Japan?
It was done beforehand. All of this stuff was done summer of 79. And then my Japanese holiday took place in 1980. And that is a bit unfortunate, because it will be seen by some people as to be a bit of a frozen jam. But actually, it's a working title stuff. When I did the show, I was always imagining having sort of and all of that on it. Because this was I was just doing this for my own insanity, and I wasn't taking it as a record. And I like doing all that. But I couldn't think of a title for it. I was hoping it would be called. I was hoping I could think of something like Crystalline Wonder. I was looking for something short, but said that, you know, that postcard you see of winter in Japan with Mount Fuji and snow on the top. Snow-capped Fuji, you know, it might have been called, or something like that. I was looking for something pretty. But I couldn't think of anything, so to remind myself what it was all about, I just wrote down in the box Frozen Jam, meaning you're frozen, that's the ice, jam, it's vaguely oriental. And it stuck, you know, and I was working with other people to make that.
And you weren't tempted to change the title for the last one?
So, I wasn't going to change it, but it turned out that in Japan, the word Jap is like still thought of as being very derogatory. Although I think over here it's been diffused a lot. I think like the man who's got a clothes firm, who's a Japanese guy, calls himself Jap, because the clothes name Jap. I think things like that have brought it for me a little bit more into line with Yank and Lime and Tom. You know, they're not as offensive as like Wok. And there are certain ones that are well offensive to you. You know, those are the ones you don't use. And I think the Japanese think that Jap is still in that kind of thing. For me, it's becoming a borderline case because of a lot of Japanese in the West, their own attitude to it. So anyway, out of not wanting to kind of do a snub to anybody who might be offended, in Japan we've called it frozen Japanese. This is a little bit timid, you know, but rather than offending.
What is your, if it's possible, Tom, in your situation, what's your inspiration to write? I mean, it must be very difficult for you to have any material ambitions.
Yeah, but it's never really been a material ambitions, you know. I mean, I remember we did used to sit around when we were just starting. We started to build our groups one. And we did sit around and kind of think, okay, now we'll write a swimming pool.
Yes.
Yeah, let's write a swimming pool. Let's write the garage. Let's write a car to go in it. But that was never really the big incentive. I don't think that's what made us write the songs. So now that in part of the incentive isn't particularly there, you know, because I've got the car and the garage and that. But I don't really think it was ever what I was writing for. Or else I probably wouldn't write now if I didn't feel like that. I sort of write because I can't help it, because it's a bit of a hobby still. It's something that, if I'm in the mood, I really like to just go and do.
So, is it true to say that you don't really have any concrete ambitions now? You don't think, well, I'd like to get into a totally different field of writing?
I do, you know, I have a lot of ambitions. The awkward thing is, whenever I do interviews, someone says that, you know, what's left, Paul?
Yes.
You know, what's left?
Well, I think...
the other one is, Paul, if, just if, that's the other question. It's a little bit of an in-joke, that one. No, but, sorry, I've got off the track. What were we talking about?
Well, this, for example, getting back to the solo album, in one sense, you know, with great respect for everything you've said, it's still basically Paul McCartney working in the field of contemporary rock music.